Good luck with the next chapter. How many times have you said that or posted that or heard that said about someone in the past couple of months? Sobrang daming tao who have been making big career moves, big career changes these past few months. And so let's talk about that for today's episode of Paano Ba To? Hello, Supers! I've been getting a lot of messages from you guys about, yeah, how do you know that it's time to make that change? So for today, we're changing things up. We're not just having one conversation, but I'm having three conversations. I wanted to get different backgrounds, different industries, different life stages. And so we are speaking with Zelfa, who changed industries, Patrick, who moved companies, and Nicole, who said goodbye to her role and is still looking forward to what is next. So first, let's talk to Zelfa. She is 29 years old, and after working in an agency for over a year, she decided to move where she really wants to work, the development sector. What are the things that she had to think about and do before making this big decision? Watch this.
COVID gave me a lot of time to think. And one of the things that I was left alone to think about was, of course, my career. I guess the key questions that I asked myself during that period. First one was, what am I good at now? And then second is, what do I want to do? The first question, the answer was, I feel comfortable with what I know now when it comes to communications. I felt answering that my intention or like my goal going into the agency world was kind of fulfilled already. And then, yun nga, the second question, the answer has always been to communications for the development sector. I was like, okay, if I have the clear answers to those two questions, why am I not there yet?
Those are two very seemingly simple but important questions that we don't really think about when we're busy fulfilling a job every day. So the pause seemed to be instrumental for you. In big career moves, it's usually our family, our loved ones who are most concerned about us, you know. So how did that play a part in your decision-making process?
My family, talagang, they're a big part of every decision I make, especially when it comes to finances. Actually, for the longest time, I had to help send my siblings to school. I had to help pay the bills. So although we're in a better place now than before, that process of consulting with everyone in the family that would be affected if there were changes in my financial status, that stuck with us pa rin. So everything, like whenever there are decisions that had to be made that might impact your ability to contribute, it was always a family discussion talaga. I needed to gather courage to ask them. I wanted to make this move. It was just over breakfast that we were discussing this. I was like, Ma, I think I really want to pursue the development world now. But I'm just worried about, you know, all these things that you have to pay, or maybe like, because my youngest brother is still studying. So then actually my mom and my sister told me, like, for the first time in my entire life, we finally can handle it. And then my sister, she also told me, she was like, everything's going well for me as well with her career. I think I can handle without your contribution. At the end of that whole discussion, my mom and my sister just smiled at me and said, just do whatever you want. This is what makes you happy, then go. It worked out.
It all worked out, I guess, really at the right time.
Yeah, it did. Couldn't imagine asking them the same question maybe 2 years ago when we were really, you know, having a hard time. But now they're also confident in the way they're handling their resources.
So to someone who has been thinking about a big career move, madami sila, especially during this quarantine. Of course, we don't want to tell them what to do, right? But I hope that you can share what you think is a really important factor that they should think about before making that decision.
The only thing that's been really constant, it's always been the people around me. You know, I keep this really, really tight-knit group of people who I trust have my best interest at heart. That includes my close friends and family, of course. And they've been really, really instrumental in all the things that I've been empowered to do, especially when it comes to my career. Choose this group of people wisely who you trust to give you the right advice. Once you have that special group of people, if you're planning to make a career move, of course, you talk to them, you consult them, but weigh their opinions against yours and against the risks that you are facing at that particular point in your life. For me, it was finances. All these things, these are valid factors that should and will affect your career decisions. So just weigh it against that.
I love that. Thank you so much for sharing your story. Maraming salamat. So from Zelfa, who is just finally getting started in the career she really wants, let's move on to Patrick. He is 30 years old and for 6 years, he was working in a telco for digital and social media, what he really loves to do. He also loves his workmates, and so it came as a shock to me that he decided to move companies. What were the things that Patrick thought about before making this big decision? Let's listen to Patrick.
I've been in my last company for 6 years, and one of the biggest realizations that I had was I'm really looking for growth. I was really happy with my job. I love what I do in my previous job. And I also love the company that I worked for. Pero I think there was a realization lang that medyo antagal ko na sa company. So I'm really hungry for a fresh start or something new. Yung unang pumasok sa isip ko was to study in Europe, like masters, ganyan. Although, of course, the pandemic happened. So, hindi rin siya natuloy for me and for other personal reasons then. I guess, yung pandemic talaga really started affecting me, my well-being. I was starting to feel burnt out. There are several factors about that. I think I'm not alone when I say this, that the pandemic has really put us into a cycle. Every day, you're doing the same thing. You wake up, you take a bath, and then you sit down and look at your laptop and then work. And then you repeat it again. There has come to a time na parang I was already dreading work days and I was always looking forward to weekends. There I realized na I really have to do something about it, that I really have to explore. So I went back to the drawing board. Ano ba yung gusto kong gawin? Or ano ba yung gusto kong growth? I looked for opportunities outside and I found a global retail brand. And I was privileged enough to give it a chance to take the job.
Such an interesting story, and seemingly just following you on social media, I would have never known that. That was the real story. So thank you for sharing that. I do know that in your previous job, you were sort of surrounded by like family, diba? You genuinely love your workmates. And for a lot of people right now, that's a big factor that is stopping them from making that big career move. Yung leaving something comfortable and familiar where you feel loved, which is so important in a job, right? And so how did you get over that hurdle?
Hindi kaya ako nakaka-get over. It's actually the hardest part of everything. Kasi of course, I was happy that I found a new job and I found this amazing brand that would like to work with me. But I realized na, oh my God, it's time to say goodbye. I was only looking for an opportunity, you know. I didn't realize na, oh my God, I have to leave my best friends. Matagal ko rin siyang tinago to people because I really had to take my time to really have that courage to tell them. Pero, of course, that's the reality that we have to move on. And actually, I also realized na while it's the hardest part, the pandemic actually made it easier somehow because you weren't together physically. It's double-sided. It's hard because you weren't able to say goodbye personally, but it's also easier because parang wala lang nangyari. You can still chat, you can still do your Zoom calls after work, diba? So parang yun yung two-pronged result of the pandemic to saying goodbye to people, I guess.
Oh my goodness. But like you said, it's a choice that you make for yourself kasi and yes, your growth, exactly. Your well being is really top priority. To someone who has been thinking about a career move but hasn't had the courage yet to do it, what is one important factor you think they should think about to help them make that big decision?
Ito talaga yung naging guiding principle ko when I decided is to really find your happiness. Sobrang cliche niya, but kung saan ka talaga magiging masaya, dun ka pumunta. Kasi whatever decision you make, kahit pumalpa ka man or kung ano mamangyari, you'll be happy with that decision if you make that decision. Makinig ka lang sa sarili mo. Don't mind the happiness of other people. Just be selfish for once. I mean, think of yourself. I think yun talaga yung magdadala sa'yo ng genuine happiness. Kahit ano man yung maging outcome of your decision.
Oh, I love that. Thank you, Patrick.
Also.
So from Patrick, who was really looking more towards growth, let's move on to the story of Nicole. Nicole is 34 years old and safe to say she has been at the top of her game for the past few years. After working for 12 years in a company she loves, what made her decide to say, okay, it's time for the next chapter? Let's listen to Nicole.
I was, you know, in the company for 12 years. I did a lot of different kinds of marketing jobs. I handled a lot of brands. I worked on several markets. I worked in several countries. I led so many kinds of teams. And in that process, I figured out what I really liked to do, what I didn't like to do, what I was good at, and what I'd say the things that didn't really come as naturally to me. And that's, you know, the beauty of having such a long career that I guess, you know, you get a lot of experience from. You figure out really what you like and you don't like. And because I was very clear about what I liked and what I knew was a position that if the company put me in, I would be at my best. So I was very clear with what that was and came to a point where the company was like, as much as we want to put you in that job, it's not available at the moment. And I thought, okay, then if it's really not going to happen, our roles are maybe 2 to 3 years long. That meant, you know, another 2 to 3 years of me doing a job where I wasn't, I feel, at my best for the company. At that point, I thought, you know, this is the right time already. It's not like I have anything left to prove in the company. I got much farther than I thought I would. You know, I was ending my assignment on a high with the business. I was handing off a very, very healthy business. So I thought it was the right time also to go. And at the same time, I felt like, okay, after 12 years, it was the right time for me to take a personal break also. I think it's still the middle of the pandemic, but I mean, for everybody, it really took a toll, right? Mentally, physically, emotionally, on everybody. So I thought, why not now? That was kind of my thought process. It was a now or never decision. And I really thought that it was the right time. Sometimes even good relationships have to end. That was the decision.
Oh my goodness. Wow. A lot of people are thinking about, should I make that move? Should I make that change? Mm. But one of the most common, I guess, factors that make that decision hard for them is that fear of the unknown, right? Which is actually the step you are in now because you haven't actively taken on what you want to do next. So how did you get over that hurdle, leaving something you know you're good at for the unknown?
Let me start first by giving two very important disclaimers. One is, going into this, I had a financial cushion. It's not like I didn't save up enough money or have enough money in the bank that I would be worried about when my next paycheck would come. The second thing is, I don't have kids or I don't have any financial responsibilities. My parents, for example, are self-sufficient. So I think those are two very important
things that people need to know. Definitely. Thank you for clearing that.
The message that I said in my TED talk was always to do something so big that it scares you. I can't say that I've determined what that next big thing is for me yet, but this step of stopping something, courageously choosing myself and my life, is probably a scary but exciting thing, because what it does is it opens up possibilities for something I probably wouldn't have considered. For 18 years, I danced ballet, and if you talk to me at that point, it was like, I'm going to be a ballet dancer forever and ever and ever. Amen. Like, I was going to go to Juilliard and all of that. And then I went into college, and then I went into the student government, completely different. And then my mind was like, I'm going to go into politics. I'm going to take law. I'm going to run for the government. And then I ended up going into PNG, and it was like, yeah, I'm going to be in corporate. So I feel like now closing this chapter in my life opens up a new possibility for me. I can reinvent myself again. And so that unknown, as scary as it is also very exciting for me. It opens up something that, you know, I adore, that I wouldn't have gone through if I stayed in PNG.
I love framing fear not as something scary, but as something inspiring. That makes so much sense in your life. Okay, to someone who has been thinking about a career move or a career change, what for you do you think is one important factor that they should think about to help them make that decision?
If you're mulling over a change in career or a change in company, I think you also need to be clear what you're trying to achieve. Is it a promotion that you're not able to get? Is it, you know, more training in a company that can provide you more than where you currently are? Is it a location? Is it pay? Very, very practical reasons. Be clear on why you're even thinking about it to begin with. Once you're clear with that, be truthful with yourself and ask whether you are running towards something or running away from something. If you're running towards something, by all means, go for it. That means, you know, it is a much better opportunity for you for whatever reason is important to you. But if you're running away from something, thing, that is something that you need to think about. Are you giving up too easily? I've gone through it before. I gave a resignation letter before to PNG, and it was exactly the same advice that was given to me by my mentor back then. And I realized, you know, I was being a little bit of a brat at that time. It was just ego. And so clearly I was running away from something. That's my advice. Think about what you want out of this job. At the end of the day, it is a job. Once you are clear with that, then ask yourself the question, are you running towards something or away from something?
I love that. Thank you so much.
Thank you also.
So, Supers, I know a lot of you have been thinking about a career move or a career change, and how do you know if it's time? I hope that the stories of Zelpha and Patrick and Nicole will help guide you in asking yourself the right questions. If you are looking for more nuggets of wisdom from my three guests, the full version, as always, will be up on Paano Ba To the podcast. You can stream and follow that for free on Spotify. I hope you enjoyed that episode. And again, I will see you in our Paano Ba To Kumustahan group, our private Facebook group. Till our next episode, stay safe, Supers!